you talk of Africa, Africa is the cradle of civilization. To date, there is no fossil remains of the human species that is older than the one found in the old Okonjo Iweala in Tanzania. And it's also not surprising that, you know, it's human nature. When you evolve, you want to make sure that you destroy your basis of evolution. And it's not surprising that the other species, because when we have our four, five species now of human beings, the Caucasians, the Negroids, and the Asians, the Mongoloids, three of them. The other two species have to move far away from their base. And that is why they are interested in destroying their base. You see that gradually, through evolution, they don't look very much like us. But I think the critical issue that we need to look at as Africans is the fact that these other species, our brothers and sisters, will not be able to achieve their machinations for Africa if they don't use us. And that is why if you look at what is happening in Africa, it's that it's the fellow African that is used to decimate the ambitions of other Africans. People that are taken out, trained by the Breton Wood institutions, by my fellow colleague Lufatu, brought back to Africa to churn out policies that will make sure that we don't develop as nations in Africa.
And the likes
have been trained to come and make sure that they nip in the bud our dreams of becoming developed nations. Are we going to allow them to succeed?
No.
Are we going to allow them to succeed?
No.
So what do? We face them, challenge them, and make sure that all their machinations are exposed. Comrades, there is no alternative to education. Franz Fanon said, knowledge dispels fear. If you know, that's exactly why in the last struggle, ASUU had never been afraid. Because we know. If I know what are your capabilities, how would you pose a threat to me? And that is why I think, comrades, the challenge is we should make sure that whatever we do, we avail Nigerians and Africans of quality education. That is the only way we can ensure that Africans are liberated. I've been to South Africa. Yes, Nelson Mandela tried. It was good. He got political power in South Africa. But what about economic power? The blacks in Africa, in South Africa, do they have economic power?
No.
They don't.
Yeah.
Why is it that here in Nigeria, more than 70% of the citizens are languishing in abject poverty? What is the secret behind that? It's the same thing. It's blacks like you and me with brown eyes and black hair that are leading the country. But why is it that while Brazil, Venezuela, and other countries can boast of more than 70% of their citizens living above the poverty line, here in Nigeria, more than 70% are languishing below the poverty line? I think to me that is one challenge that we must face squarely and address. And I put it to you, the only way we can do that is to avail Nigerians and Africans of high quality education. That was the secret behind the last province of ASUU. We have not succeeded matching. We have gotten concessions. But for me, the struggle has just begun. And that's exactly why the challenge before every right-thinking Nigerian or African is that we must continue to struggle to ensure that we get leaders that are thinking as Africans and Nigerians. Not leaders who fear the color of someone's skin. What is happening in your leadership echelon, comrades, is that when they see the white man, they're afraid, they're shaking. In the words of Eskotoyo, these are slaves. We can't have slaves as our leaders. The liberated people of Nigeria and Africa must stand up and take over the mantles of leadership. How come, comrades, that the greatest data nation in the world is calling the shots? If you look at the debt profile of America, internal and external, there's no other country in the world that has that level of debt. But America is still calling the shots because we are stupid.
Yes.
Comrades, I think the challenge is for us to make sure that we put everybody in its proper perspective.
Yes.
Recently, I was in Oxford. They made the mistake of taking me to one palace, Blenheim Palace. They said it's one of the eight palaces that are spread across UK. You need to see the opulence in that palace. Tapestry with painted gold, tables and chairs with solid gold legs. I was sitting internally. When we came back, they made the mistake of allowing me to talk. I said, I've seen thieves. People who stole the wealth of the colonies. I said, I'm not happy because this wealth that we see in Blenheim Palace and the other seven palaces that we're talking about belongs to some people who are now languishing in abject poverty because you have stolen their wealth. Comrades, I think it's about time we commence the process of turning the table around. I think it's about time we also colonize those who colonized us and stole our wealth. I'm sure we can do it. Yes. Why I'm convinced, comrades, is that at every international forum that I attended, Africans call the shots. Get so many encomiums, so many commendations. It shows that we have this. And the 21st century, comrades, it is this that matters. All we need to do is to put our acts together and call the bluff of these so-called Nigerians that are holding us on behalf of the Breton Wood institutions by the chocolate.
Yes.
It's only when we do that, we'll ensure that the struggle to liberate not just Nigerians but Africans is going to succeed. And I think the challenge to all of us, comrades, is that we shall not fail in this struggle. We can be like Pontius Pilate, continue to pontificate. But I want to assure you, pontification is not going to solve the problem. You can't continue agonizing. You must begin to organize. That's the only way we can be able to liberate not just the Nigerian, but the African. Give people the education. They will fend for themselves. Deny them education, they will remain slaves. That's why when I moved across Nigeria,
I see beggars everywhere.
Yes.
It's only a matter of style. But I come to you and looking very smart and ask you, my friend, I lost my wallet. I want to get to so-so place. Help me. Is that not begging?
Begging.
So there are beggars everywhere in Nigeria. And I think it's, it behoves you and me to make sure that we liberate them.
Yes.
The secret is that our so-called leaders are cashing on the approach of the colonial masters. Divide our rule. Why should your tribe, your region, be a matter of import? I want to ask you a question. I've asked this several. Were you consulted before it was decided who your parents are going to be?
No.
Or where, in which part of the world are you going to be created? Or in which tribe, so many tribes in the world, in which tribe you're going to come out? Were you consulted?
No.
Then why should that be a problem? You don't have the same in that. So why should it be a problem if you come from South Africa, or you come from Cairo, or you come from Nigeria? Why should that be a problem? The other mundane issue that they've been pushing into us is religion. If I decide today I want to worship this body, it's my own problem. When I die, I will see whether I was right or wrong. So why should that be a problem? It's your cross, you decide to carry it whichever way. It should be a problem. So why should somebody amplify that as a problem to make sure that you and me do not work together to face them? I think, comrades, what we need to do is to make sure that these mundane sentiments are checked. And how we do that? We educate people. We educate people to make sure that they are enlightened enough to know that these differences do not matter. What matters is that how many Nigerians can fend for themselves? How many Nigerians, how many Africans are living above the poverty line? How many Nigerians, how many Africans can be able to create jobs for people? I think that is the most important challenge. And I want to assure you that our union, ASUU, in a union of intellectuals, will continue to chart a course for this country. Make sure that we liberate our country within the shortest possible time. I want to encourage that we will continue to work. You see, the issue is that we are not blind. We continuously are being deceived. Recently, people are happy that there is crisis from among the people who are leading us. There is a letter. Who told you that the person who wrote the letter might not have been mobilized to write the letter so that it will appear to you and me that there is a crisis in their camp and then we will relax, waiting for an opportunity to benefit from the outcome of the crisis? If we were to plan and get them out, within 1 year, 2 years, we continue to wait for them to have crisis before we do that. I assure you, we are not going to get them out. The challenge is that we have been deceived before. We should never allow ourselves to be deceived again. That is the challenge. Aluta, Victoria, divided, we bargain. United, we bargain. Divided with them. We cannot afford to be beggars. Thank you very much.